What's going on, Faithful? This is Aaron Wilson for Inside the 49. Wanted to jump back on YouTube to break down a couple plays for you guys from the 49ers' big win over the Dallas Cowboys last week in the wild card playoffs. If you're like me, you were stressed out pretty much after the first quarter until the very, very last second of the game. Thank God they won, and now they're on to the second round of the playoffs playing against the Green Bay Packers. So let's go ahead and break down a couple plays. Specifically today, we want to talk about Juwan Jennings. He's come through this year as being a big target for Jimmy Garoppolo. He's a big third down target, especially, so we're going to break down a couple of his third down catches from last week. He totals this year with 24 catches for 282 yards and 5 touchdowns. So he's been a big part of the team, stepping in for Mohamed Sanu and pretty much taking his role, and the 49ers not really needing Sanu back, which has been big for a second-year guy who didn't get any time last year. So let's go ahead and break down a couple of the plays from our big win over the Cowboys. Here we go. All right, so the first play that we're going to break down is going to be in the first quarter. The 49ers are up 7-0 already, and the ball's on the 42. This is 3rd and 10. Jimmy's doing a really good job this year on third down, getting out of those third and long situations, and he does the same thing here, and he's looking for one of his new favorite targets in Jennings. So let's check it out. All right, you kind of have a 2x2 look over here with Kittle as one of the tight ends. You got Jennings on the right-hand side, and as Shanahan always loves to do, he's going to take Jennings or someone and put him in motion. Right off the bat, we know we got man-on-man coverage. Jimmy sees it. He's got man-on-man here down to Debo on Ayuk and also Kittle. So as soon as we put Jennings in motion, we'll see that the cornerback is going to follow him. All right, so Jimmy right there is thinking, okay, I got man coverage, where do I go? And he's looking Jennings' spot the whole entire time. So we got two routes that are really going on here. You got Jennings, who's gonna run an out route about 10 yards right at the first down marker, maybe a little bit beyond it, maybe a yard ahead of it. And then you got Ayuk, who's gonna run kind of a sluggo route. So he's gonna run the slant, and he's gonna go out from there. So let's check it out. I mean, that's a dime. You can't throw it any better. If you go back and see, Jennings at the initial point where Jimmy's about to throw the ball is not only covered, he's blanketed, right? But he knows where he needs to throw the ball, and he trusts Jennings to get to that perfect spot, and that timing is on point. Bam, first down. That's what I'm talking about. Ball 3rd and 10, right? 3rd and long. All right, let's see it from the other side. All right, let's take a look at the left side of the line with our Pro Bowlers, Williams and Thomason, and see how they do. Oh, Thomason gets beat on the first move, right? Maybe a little bit of a hold here, but he ends up straightening his body out and getting in a better spot. Williams is doing a good job, gets pushed back a little bit, right? But Jimmy still has a decent pocket here. You know, he's got a couple feet to work with, but he's got to get rid of this ball quick and does a great job. Perfect pass, perfect catch, 2 feet in, bam, first down Niners. We got Lance up here, getting excited, pumping up from his team. All right, let's check out the second play. All right, second play. This is 3rd quarter, 9 minutes left, 3rd and 5, all right, 3rd and long-ish, all right, medium and long-ish. 49ers are up by 9. You know, they want to drive. They're on the 12-yard line. They want to get a nice drive out of here and score some points. Here we go. All right, again, you got a 2x2 look again. All right, but this time, as opposed to taking Jennings and moving Jennings over, you got Debo coming over to trips. All right, we got tight coverage here on Kittle, and we got a little bit of a break, you know, 5 to 10 yards with the other guys, which 5 yards for the first down, I'd be a little bit tighter if I was at DC, but that's me. The big thing that I want you to see from here is the initial break. What's the initial break from Kittle? What's the initial break from Debo? And what's the initial break from Jennings? Kittle's going to come inside. All right, Debo's going to go outside. And Jennings is going to kind of split the middle, take an initial outside release. This is important because with this type of zone coverage, we're really looking to create some space. How can we create space for Jennings? And here's how they do it. bam. I mean, what a difference, right? What a difference. But look at the initial break. Kittle, look at all that space. Kittle gets a big break to the inside, and all of a sudden it went from that tight formation to a nice wide formation. You see Debo, how far he's getting up here. This is all about creating space for Jennings, right? Jennings, same route, little 5-yard route. Nice catch, couple yards, right? But look at the space from Debo and Kittle, right? They're clearing things out for him, right? Let's look at Kittle first. Look at his first step. Big step inside. Right, gets off that jam and comes out to the middle of the field. Right, he's covered pretty well. Same thing with Debo. But look how much space he's given Jennings for the nice pass from Garoppolo for the first down. All right, let's see it from the other side. All right, the big thing here is really they're getting pressure. Right, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You got 6 guys that are acting like they're gonna go in. And the big thing is for Juice to realize, who do I need to block? And who's going to be the person that I need to account for? And that's going to be Parsons coming up the middle. And he does a great job coming through and getting him. Bam there. Okay, right? A nice little stump by 96. 96 went to the right, so Parsons go to the left. It looks like they took both their ends and actually backed the ends out. Why they're having them drop to about 2 yards? Doesn't really make sense to me. Why not just send them? You have everybody else covered. The only other person you got to really worry about is Juice if Juice comes out. So maybe they have the outside linebacker picking Juice up if he comes out of the backfield. But having both these guys here looking for a 2-yard something or escaping the pocket doesn't make sense to me. But again, Juice does a great job coming over and giving a nice block. Jimmy, poison the pocket. Bam, right to Jennings. First down already. 3 more yards after that. All right, third and final play we're going to break down. All right, now we're in the fourth quarter, up 23-17. You know, the 49ers need a score. They need a touchdown or at least a field goal to go up. We know they didn't even get there, but it's all right because they end up winning in the end. But it's third and four again. Garoppolo to Jennings. Garoppolo to Jennings again on third down. Let's check it out. All right, 2x2 formation set up again with Kittle as one of those quote-unquote wide receivers. You got Juice in the backfield and motion him out. Empty set, right? There's no help. And it's a little bit troublesome if you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 guys, right? And you only got 5 linemen, right? If they bring all these guys, it might be a little bit of a problem, right? We get lucky, they end up bringing back one of those guys on the inside, or maybe 2, I'm not 100% sure. But let's check out Jennings, who's located right down here in the slot. All right. What's nice about this is widen the formation, right? Check to see how much distance they have, right? Juice is a decoy in this situation. They're just trying to take that safety and they're trying to bring them out wide. Look at the middle of the field, right? And this is something middle of the field that they should be taking advantage of. Now, third and four, not so much, but I'm sure that Shanahan will see this on film and think, okay, if I can get safety go all the way out there with Juice, middle of the field, nobody's back there, right? Even if they're taking those linebackers and dropping those linebackers back, it's still wide open. This time we get a nice little sit down route at the first down marker from Jennings. Oh, there we go. Let me get the release going deep by those 2 cornerbacks / safeties. So all of a sudden the middle of the field isn't as wide open as we thought saw it originally. All right, this is a big thing to think about when you're looking at defenses. It's not just where they sign up, line up at the very beginning. It's really where they're going to eventually be at the snap. Nice sit by Jennings, right? Right at the first down marker, maybe a yard ahead of it, and sits down there. There's no way this lineman / linebacker, I'm not sure who this is here, I assume it's a middle linebacker, is able to be, he's going to try to pop back and get there, right? He's not going to have the wheels, right, to be able to get there before Jennings. Parsons is the same thing on this side, and he actually ends up getting to Kittle and being on Kittle, but Jennings, they're not able to get to Jennings with this single linebacker. Let's check it out one more time. It's just too much space for him to handle. All right, let's see it from the other side. My man Brown acting like that's not a first down coming up, shaking his hand. Give me a break. Let's see that again real quick. No first down, no first down. Yeah, give me a break, dude. All right, other side. All right, here it is again. Let's check out Parsons. Check out 92. as they drop, right? And think about Jennings all the way over there, right? There's no way 92's gonna get there, all right? Let's check it out. Initial release, right? Parsons gets to his spot where he needs to go to. 92 does not get deep enough. This is all about spacing, guys. It's really all about spacing, right? So if we look at Jennings, right? If Jennings is tighter, closer to this DN, right? And then runs that same route, it's not there. It's all about spacing it out. So let's check out how Juice changes the spacing. All right. So Juice changes it. All right. Let's see. This is the initial setup, right? 27 should probably be on Kittle. Right? He's following Kittle, right? But just look at it here, the defense. And now look at the spacing here and how much wider they are. And that's what it's all about. First down Jennings. All right, we've been saying that a lot this year, and hopefully we'll be saying it a lot more on Saturday night in Green Bay. Hope you guys enjoyed this. To stay up to date on all the 49ers news and information, check out Inside the 49 on Twitter and InsideThe49.com. Go Niners!